my dear friends. First of all, I'm very happy that some of our media friends have accompanied me during my trip to these three nations. I have had an extremely productive visit to Botswana, Zimbabwe and Malawi. I am totally satisfied that we could successfully engage ourselves with these three nations on various issues, including cooperation, trade, exchange of information, support to India on various international forums. You are all aware that high priority our government gives to relations with Africa. In 2015, we had a Indo-African summit where the heads of various African countries were all there to participate. Meeting that was held in Delhi. There, our Prime Minister have announced a 10 guiding principles to enhance our engagement with Africa. My visit to these three countries is in this context. After this visit, you will be happy to know that in the last 4.5 years of our government, 29 visits to Africa have taken place at the level of President, Vice President, and the Prime Minister. This is truly unprecedented. My visit was significant particularly because this is the first ever high-level visit to these three countries after a long gap. In fact, Zimbabwe, it was after 21 years, and President of Zimbabwe was very appreciative. That too, I have visited Zimbabwe after his election as the president. The leadership of these three countries have received me with a great ramp. The President of Botswana, who had a prior commitment of a state visit to Mozambique, flew back to meet me and spent more than an hour with me to discuss various issues of mutual interest. The President of Malawi himself hosted a state lunch along with the First Lady, in my honor, and it's not of much significance because, the Indian side have informed them because normally I try to avoid non-vegetarian food outside, though I'm a non-vegetarian. So as a matter of a gesture, they made the entire lunch vegetarian. That's not a big issue, but the gesture I'm mentioning. Further, India and these three African countries that we share the similar values, common bonds of democracy, and a shared history of colonialism. That is one thing makes them to feel more closer to India. In fact, eight of our observers of the Election Commission were there during the Zimbabwe elections, and they expressed satisfaction about the conduction of these elections. My visit was to build a strong foundation and take our relations to the next level by reinforcing the existing ties and forging relations in the new areas. The outcome of my visit clearly indicates that this has been achieved. I am particularly happy that we could discuss issues in depth and come to meaningful conclusions on various issues. These are the countries which India has strongly supported in their socio-economic development. This was unequivocally acknowledged by all the three presidents. In fact, Zimbabwe president openly thanked that standing by them during their period of isolation. They were very appreciative of India's role. All leaders thanked India for the sustained developmental assistance extended through line of credit and grants to various projects. You are aware, India-Africa Summit 3, India has agreed to extend line of credit to Africa, $10 billion. Over the 5 years, in addition to $600 million as a grant. During my visit, I made substantial commitment to them on developmental partnership and also our assistance on major commitments made includes $350 million for projects in Zimbabwe, $220 million of lines of credit for water supply projects in Malawi, as well as setting up Mahatma Gandhi Convention Center in Zimbabwe as well as in Malawi. As a grant, these are all grants. My announcements were gratefully acknowledged by their leadership. Capacity building was of special interest in all these three countries. The leadership of events a keen interest, and they were uniformly appreciative of the ITEC programs and the generous slots we have given for training of their national in a variety of fields. In Botswana, I offered to increase the slots from current 140 per year. We have also agreed to depute the experts training of their junior diplomats. We are also deputing 5 experts in various fields to assist Zimbabwe under ITEC. President of Malawi specially asked for assistance for development, skill development, which I have readily agreed to. I invited all of them to participate actively in the tele-education, tele-medicine projects India has launched recently across Africa. We are also getting 1 lakh textbooks of the NCRT for classes 3rd to 12th in Malawi. Trade investments were another area where these three countries saw considerable potential for enhancing engagement with India. We discussed several areas of engagement, especially in the areas of agriculture, health, pharmaceutical, ICT, minerals, mining, diamond trading, railways, because our rights is already working here, and infrastructure, logistics, etc. All the three leaders were highly appreciative of the role India, our public sector, is playing in investing in their respective countries and contributing to their development. The Indian private sector's role was highly appreciated by these leaders. They mentioned project after project where Indian companies are taking up construction of bridges, rights, construction of roads, then other even power project, energy projects, water line projects. We had a special discussion with regard to minerals because they have rare earth minerals and their trading came in for specific discussion. Since all these three countries are rich in minerals including uranium, copper, nickel, etc., we signed MOU with Malawi on providing capacity building in nuclear energy regulatory framework. This is very important on its protection, safety, etc., keeping in mind rich deposits of uranium in the a rare earth mineral in Malawi. We also signed MOU on geology, mining, minerals with Zimbabwe. Direct trading in raw diamonds was also discussed with Botswana and Zimbabwe. In the area of health, all the three countries were deeply appreciative of medical services in India as well as their services being rendered by our private sector. I just read yesterday one of the popular drama actor is being flown to India today for a kidney transplantation. They are all appreciative of the medical care that is being provided in Delhi, which is comparatively cheaper. Earlier they all used to go to South Africa and other countries. Now India is becoming slowly the destination. Yesterday this news was prominently published in local media. I also mentioned about the Indian traditional medicines, particularly Ayurveda and Yoga. All these countries have shown immense interest in promoting Ayurveda and Yoga because they have their own traditional medicines as well. And we signed an MOU on traditional medicine with Zimbabwe. In all the three countries, I had an opportunity to interact with the local and Indian businessmen and Indian companies operating there. In Botswana, they gave me the privilege, honor, of inaugurating the expo, annual global expo at Botswana, where for the first time, 28 Indian companies have participated. I also visited the diamond trading company in Botswana. I also unveiled the project to inaugurate the business incubation center in Malawi, built with Government of India's assistance. Agriculture is one area of focus which I myself have stressed. They have also evinced a keen interest because they are all agriculture based economies, and we have expertise in agriculture because agriculture is our basic culture. They were willing to even engage with Indian agriculturists. They asked us to make Indian agriculture to join partnership with the local people, communities, and also in some of the discussions it came up for taking the land on lease or developing the barren land, including drip irrigation, dry land irrigation, horticulture. These are some of the areas, and we are setting up a India-Africa Institute for Agriculture and Rural Development in Malawi, which will cater to the whole of Africa on training and capacity building, because value addition will be of immense help in agriculture sector for these countries. I promise to explore the greater possibility of involvement from our side, particularly in value addition and food processing. We have also agreed as a guest chair to import mangoes from Malawi as a special guest chair. Defense sector is another area where there is greater scope for cooperation with all the countries. We have been able to successfully conclude the negotiations during my visit for sending Indian Army training team to Botswana, with whom we had close defense relations since 1978. We are extending training starts of defense to Zimbabwe and Malawi. All the three leaders agreed for security cooperation, particularly in counter-terrorism needs, to be strengthened. We discussed at length. I myself took the initiative of focusing the attention on fighting terror and speaking with one voice. They all agreed that we have to take this agenda forward and impress upon the United Nations for combined action to tackle the source of funding to terror and isolate them. The other important agreements included extradition treaty with Malawi and an agreement in broadcasting by Prasara Bharati. Another one in arts, culture, heritage and action plan and ICT with Zimbabwe. One thing that makes them more comfort is the cultural relations we have. There is much more common between the countries. I met the Indian community in all the three countries. I am happy to say that Indian community or diaspora and NRIs in this country are playing an important role in the economic development and also highly regarded by their leadership for their industry and hard work in my interaction. Some of our Indians who settled here, they have become senators, parliamentarians, and one of them is a deputy minister in the Zimbabwe government, one Mr. Modi. I invited them to India to participate in the Pravasa Bharatiya Divas in January 2019, and I told them that they can as well attend Republic Day functions as well as the Kumbha Snan, which is very important to many people. All these three countries have been supporting India's cause in the international fora, and they have further made commitment that they will stand by India in the international fora on other occasions also. All the three leaders, they have expressed desire to work with India on solar energy. They are also highly appreciative of India's initiative on international solar alliance, where Malawi has already signed and ratified the framework. Zimbabwe has signed ISA during my visit to Botswana. They conveyed to me their decision to sign it shortly. These are indeed welcome developments. I was very happy to inaugurate the unique event, India for Humanity. This event is to commemorate the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi by year-long service camps of the well-known Jaipur Foot Camp in all parts of Africa, but in all parts of the world, particularly in all parts of Africa. The government is partnering with Bhagavan Mahavir Vikalang Sahayata Samiti in this India for Humanity initiative. I launched the very first Jaipur Foot Camp in this series yesterday in Malawi. Malawi was chosen since it was in Africa that Mahatma spent more than 20 years and eventually led a non-violent movement that liberated India from colonialism and inspired African leaders to free their countries as well. We were there for yesterday, friends, in Zimbabwe. We were shown the Heroes Acre, that is a national memorial for heroes who participated in the struggle, sacrificed their life and made contribution. I was particularly happy to note one of the Indians, Sri Kanti Bhai Govardhan Bhai Patel, who migrated here in 1961, settled here, made a humble beginning as a small trader, but expanded his activity. Later, on seeing the colonial oppression, he joined the movement and then he became an active participant. They told me, the foreign minister told me, that he not only gave shelter to the underground guerrillas during the struggle, but also gave them information and also financial assistance as and when required. And they have erected a memorial for him with his photo, and I was there to visit the tomb and then offer tribute. Overall, I am very happy at the substantial and substantial outcome of my visit to these three countries, that what India has been aiming to achieve. I am very happy about the overall visit. I am particularly happy the response of the Indian diaspora. We are all very, very happy about the growth story of India. And the leadership also, to my surprise, even the deep of Africa, they are all aware of the happenings and the reforms initiatives of our Prime Minister in India. They are all very happy, appreciative about the growth rate. And the President of Zimbabwe and Botswana, they have mentioned you are sending man to the moon, and also your economy also is reaching like that. So that means they are all keenly watching what is happening in India. Any questions, please?
Thank you very much, sir. We are about to land shortly, but we may have time for one question, if that's okay. Vilas?
Good morning, sir. Vilas Tokle from the Press Trust of India, PTI. After your high-level visit to these three countries in Africa, what is your perception about how these countries perceive or view some of our neighbors?
They are also aware of what is happening, and they are one with us about the need to put down terror and the need to stop funding of terror. On this, there is common understanding. They are all appreciative of what is happening. I have explained to them that India want to have friendly relations with all our neighbors, and I have also briefed them about the gesture of our Prime Minister visiting the Pakistani counterpart even for a function at his home, and the efforts that are being made. And then the subsequent actions of these people. So they are also aware of what is happening. And they all, as I told, are appreciative of the need to come together to put an end to terror and to speak one voice. And they are also in agreement with us on two things. One, that the United Nations must come out strongly. And some of these countries, I'm happy to note that Botswana, they are also taking steps to curb black money, stringent laws to unearth black money, and also to confiscate properties. And I was hearing some of the steps during our delegation, our talks. I was just thinking what was happening in India on these lines. Same thing, similar things are happening. They're all taking steps on that. And second, they also agree with us the need to democratize the United Nations in a more effective manner, and the importance of the role of India in the United Nations.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you all for joining.
Thank you all. I hope that you've taken care during the trip.